Hi friends, I'm Ujjwal Rathore and welcome to YouTube channel It's All About English. Topic for today's video is how to improve spoken English. In this video, we will learn some really easy and truthful tricks to improve communication skills. If you use them, for sure you will feel a drastic change in your communication skills within a few days. So here we are. First tip is don't be scared. English can be scary language for some people. They're scared of making mistakes. They're scared if they will not speak precisely, people will make fun of them. So first trick is don't be scared about making a mistake. If you are scared, you can't speak fluently ever. So let your fear go. Remember, it doesn't have to be perfect when you are learning. There's a saying in English, it always seems impossible until it's done. Now, second tip is listen, watch, and imitate. We have spent probably thousands of hours locked up in the room, studying tables of rules and vocabulary list, but we still can't say anything. Most people think that reason that this happens is because material or teacher is not good enough. But that's not true at all. Listening is perhaps the most important skill in any language learning. The fact is that any language is best learned when there is a lot of opportunity to listen. Remember, we learn our mother tongue by listening only. So start listening to English language as much as possible. You can listen to English songs or English news. For English songs, you can Google the lyrics of that particular song, and once you have lyrics in your hand or in front of you, sing along. This way, you realize you have enhanced your vocab, fluency, and correct pronunciation. And watch English shows, cartoons, movies with subtitles like Friends. And you can also watch news channels like BBC or CNN. Imitate or repeat their dialogues the way they do. This way, soon you will realize that you are speaking fluently and get enough content and a lot of words also added to your vocabulary. Now, next one is think and talk to yourself in English. If you talk to yourself in English, this will force you to start thinking in English. English will automatically start pouring out of your mouth. Reason is you are not spending time on translation. So start think and talk to yourself in English. Next one is pre-plan your dialogues. As a new learner, we are thinking so much about what we should say next. So pre-plan your dialogues according to the situation you are going to face. For example, you are going to visit a beauty parlor. So take a notepad and write down dialogues for every possible situation. Now imagine that you are at beauty parlor. How would you start your conversation? You can start it like this. Hello, I'm here for the haircut. Then beautician can ask you, how would you like your haircut, ma'am? Then you can reply, I only want a trim. Or you can say, can you cut about 2 inches of the length? Prepare this way your dialogues. In this way, you will be sure that whatever you are saying is correct, and this will concrete 100% confidence in you. And you will start to feel less nervous when you have to speak English. Now, next one is speak. It will be hard at first. You won't know how to say things. It will be embarrassing. You will hesitate a lot and feel frustrated that you can't say things precisely the way you want to. This will happen even if you study for decades, until you don't use this language in your day-to-day life. Speak well whenever you get an opportunity, even if it is in broken sentences. Take that opportunity and speak. The more you practice talking in English, the better you will be. Now, last one is consistent practice. Consistent practice boosts motivation and keeps the language fresh in your mind. So yes, you need to give quality time to practice it. Make a commitment to yourself that yes, I will do consistent practice. For consistent practice, each day you can choose a new verb, noun, adjective, idiom, etc. that you are not familiar with, and find a way to use it in a conversation. Make a promise to yourself that every month you will read a new book in English. Instead of picking up a newspaper in your native language, pick up the newspaper in English. If you practice enough, you will get the other side very quickly. So guys, these were a couple of tips. I hope you found these tips helpful. Please share your feedback in the comment section below. And thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.